Suratol-Qadr, or Inna Anzalnat, is the 97th chapter of the Holy Quran. It is a Makki surah, in the 30th juz of the Holy Quran. The name, Al-Qadr, comes from the first verse of the chapter, which refers to the revelation of the Holy Quran, in the night of Qadr. Suratol-Qadr is about the greatness, virtues and blessings of the night of Qadr, and the descent of the angels of mercy to earth, on that night. Shias appeal to the content of the chapter, to argue for the necessity of the existence of an infallible Imam on earth, until the day of resurrection. The recitation of the chapter is recommended, in obligatory daily prayers, and some recommended optional prayers. It is also recommended that the chapter be recited 1,000 times in nights of Qadr. In general, Suratol-Qadr is about the revelation of the Holy Quran, in the night of Qadr. The greatness of the night of Qadr, being superior to 1,000 months, the descent of the angels of mercy, and the spirit, the predestination of people's fates, and the blessings of this night. Suratol-Qadr is the 25th chapter revealed to the Prophet Muhammad, sallallahu alaihi wa sallam, in the order of revelation. In the current order of compilation, this chapter is the 97th chapter of the Holy Quran. It has 6 verses including Bismillah. Now let's please listen to the verses of Suratol-Qadr.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim.
In the name of Allah, the All-Beneficent, the All-Merciful.
Inna anzalnahu fi laylatil qadr.
Indeed, we sent it down on the night of ordainment.
وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ مَا لَيْلَةُ الْقَدْرِ.
What will show you what is the night of ordainment?
لَيْلَةُ الْقَدْرِ خَيْرٌ مِّنْ أَلْفِ شَهْرٍ.
The night of ordainment is better than 1,000 months.
تَنَزَّلُ الْمَلَائِكَةُ وَالرُّوحُ فِيهَا بِإِذْنِ رَبِّهِمْ مِّنْ كُلِّ أَمْرٍ.
In it the angels and the spirit descend by the leave of their Lord with every command.
Salamun hiya hatta matla'il fajr.
It is peaceful until the rising of the dawn.
وفي الكافي محمد بن يحيى عن أحمد بن محمد عن ابن محبوب عن سيف بن عميرة عن رجل عن أبي جعفر عليه السلام قال من قرأ إنا أنزلناه في ليلة القدر يجهر بها صوته كان كالشاهر سيفه في سبيل الله ومن قرأها سرا كان كالمتشحط بدمه في سبيل الله ومن قرأها 10 مرات غفرت له على نحو 1000 ذنب من ذنوبه.
It has been narrated from Abu Jafar alayhi salam having said, the one who recites, surely. We revealed it during the night of predetermination, Suratol-Qadr, being loud with it by his voice, would be like the brandisher of his sword, in the way of Allah the Mighty and Majestic. And one who recites it privately, would be like the one rolling in his blood, in the way of Allah the Mighty and Majestic. And one who recites it 10 times, Allah the Mighty and Majestic would forgive his sins for him approximately 1,000 sins from his sins.
وفي ثواب الأعمال وبهذا الإسناد عن الحسن عن أبيه الحسين بن أبي العلاء عن أبي عبد الله عليه السلام قال من قرأ إنا أنزلناه في فريضة من فرائض الله نادى منادي يا عبد الله غفر الله لك ما مضى فاستأنف العمل.
Ebne Babawe, by his chain, from Al-Husayn Ebne Abil Ala, it has been narrated, from Abi Abdullah alayhi salam, said, one who recites, surely we revealed it during the night of predetermination, Surat Al-Qadr, in his obligatory prayers, from the obligations of Allah, daily prayers, a caller calls out, O servant of Allah! Allah has forgiven those deeds which you had appealed for in the past, so you can resume the deeds anew.
ومن خواص القرآن روي عن النبي صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم أنه قال من قرأ هذه السورة كان له من لأجرك من صام شهر رمضان، وإن وافق ليلة القدر كان له ثواب كثواب من قاتل في سبيل الله، ومن قرأها على باب مخزن سلمه الله تعالى من كل آفة وسوء إلى أن يخرج صاحبه ما فيه.
And from Kawaz al-Quran, it has been reported from the Holy Prophet, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that he said, "One who recites this chapter, Suratol-Qadr, will have the reward for him, as if he had fasted during the month of Ramadan, and if it coincides with the night of predestination, Laylatul Qadr, he will have for him the reward similar to the reward of the one who is killed in the way of Allah the Mighty and Majestic. And one who recites it on the door of storage, Allah the Mighty and Majestic will keep it safe from every affliction and evil, until its owner takes out what is in it."
وقال الصادق عليه السلام من قرأها بعد عشاء الآخرة 15 مرة كان في أمان الله إلى تلك الليلة الأخرى، ومن قرأها في كل ليلة 7 مرات أمن في تلك الليلة إلى طلوع الفجر، ومن قرأها على ما يدخر ذهبا أو فضة أو أثاث بارك الله فيه من جميع ما يجره، وإن قرأت على ما فيه غلة نفعه بإذن الله تعالى.
And Imam al-Siddiq alayhi salam said, "One who recites it after the last part of the night, 15 times, would be in the safety of Allah the Mighty and Majestic, until the next night. And one who recites it 7 times every night, would be in safety, till the break of dawn. And one who recites on what he has saved, gold or silver or furniture, Allah the Mighty and Majestic will bless it and, it will be remote, from all harm. And if it is recited on that in which are crops, it would be beneficial by the permission of Allah the Mighty and Majestic, the Exalted."
وقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم من قرأها كان له يوم القيامة خير البرية رفيقا وصاحبا، وإن كتبت في إناء جديد ونظر فيه صاحب اللقوة شفاه الله تعالى.
And the Holy Prophet of Allah, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, said, "One who recites it, on the day of judgment there would be for him, the best of created beings, Karal Bariya, Amirul Mominin alayhi salam, as a friend and a companion. And if it is written in a new utensil, and the one with the facial paralysis looks into it, Allah the Exalted, would heal him."
في المصباح للكفعمي رحمه الله، فذكر ابن طاووس رحمه الله في محجه أنه قيل للصادق عليه السلام بما احترست من المنصور عند دخولك عليه، فقال بالله وبقراءة إنا أنزلناه، ثم قلت يا الله 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 إني أتشفع إليك بمحمد وآله صلى الله عليهم أن تقلبه لي، فمن ابتلي بمثل ذلك فليصنع مثل صنعي، ولولا أننا نقرأها ونأمر بقراءتها شيئتنا ليختطفهم الناس، ولكن هي والله لحم كحف.
In Mahajid Dawad of Ebne Tawuz, it was said to Al-Imam Asadiq alayhi salam, "How did you exercise caution when you went to Al-Mansur?" He said, "By Allah the Exalted, and by reciting Suratul Qadr." Then said, "O Allah, 7 times, I seek your intercession by Muhammad and his progeny alayhim as-salam to overturn this plague for me. So, the one who is afflicted with that, then he should do similar to what I did. And were it not for our recitation of it, and our ordering for its recitation, our Shias would have been captivated by the people, but, by Allah the Mighty and Majestic, this is a cave, shelter, for them."
في كتاب طب الأئمة بإسناده إلى أبي حمزة الثمالي عن أبي جعفر عليه السلام قال شكى رجل من حمدان إلى أمير المؤمنين وجع الظهر وأنه يسهر الليل. فقال: رع يدك على الموضع الذي تشتكي منه واقرأ ثلاثا: وما كان لنفس أن تموت إلا بإذن الله كتابا معجلا، ومن يرد ثواب الدنيا نؤته منها، ومن يرد ثواب الآخرة نؤته منها، وسنجزي الشاكرين. وقرأ سبع مرات: إنا أنزلناه في ليلة القدر إلى آخرها، فإنك تعافى من العلة إن شاء الله تعالى.
In the book Tibbale-i-Mat, by his chain going up to Abu Hamzat as-Somali. Mulaana al-Imam Abu Jafar alayhi salam said, a man from Hamdine complained to Amir al-Mu'minin alayhi salam of backache, and he was not able to sleep. He said, place your hand on the area which you are complaining of, and recite three times, no soul can die except by the permission of Allah the Exalted who has decreed its term. And one who wants the reward of the world is given from it, and one who wants the reward of the hereafter is given from it, and we recompense the thankful, and recite seven times, surely we revealed it during the night of predetermination, Suratol-Qadr, till its end. You will recover from the illness, if Allah the Exalted so desires.